This video is brought to you by my supporters on Patreon. Hey guys, salut, welcome back to the croissant series. In the previous episode, the one we shot at Utopie Bakery in Paris, I learned so much and I learned it the hard way. My croissant game, basically, how do I put this gently? It's not as amazing as I thought it was. Now, of course, I could try to improve my pastry skills, but as men do, I'm gonna start simple. I'm gonna blame the tools, okay? So this is called a dough sheeter, or in French, a laminoir. Bakers use it at least 4 times during the process. In fact, they use it to flatten the basic dough, flatten the butter slab, form the sandwich dough, and then finally they use it to reduce the thickness down of the dough at the end. And thanks to this machine right here, all those actions are performed with an incredible evenness. I need one of those. That's the reason why my croissant game is not that high. It's not. But it can definitely help, right? Now, of course, I could go and buy a commercial version of that machine, but the mechanism is not like rocket science. It's just a flattening rod and a conveyor belt underneath. Is that a big deal? No, I don't think so. Possibly. Maybe. Can be. It can. Anyways, you know me, I don't like reinventing the wheel. Think of pasta machine, dry aged beef and wok stove, so I'm just gonna build one. Now, of course, I thought about using my brilliant ramen machine to flatten this croissant dough, but the thing is, the rollers, they're just not wide enough. It's just... Oh. I'm now off to the hardware store because I need to get a few supplies. I need plywood, I need a few threaded rods, I need different types of screws, I need bearings, and of course I need a roller. To be honest, this is the thing I'm the less confident about. I've never seen a roller. Like a big, fat roller at the hardware store. I don't want to saw my rolling pin. I will if I have to. I'd love to find an alternative, so... Nope. Dad. Thin. Nope. This handle is the biggest rod or wooden rod. It's not even close to being like the thing I'm looking for. Might need to find something else. No, no, no. I found 2 table legs, which should be just fine. I hope I got everything I need, so let's head back to Le Studio. I love this moment, just the anticipation before the storm. I've been making a rail for the tray to be sliding on. The next step is to cut those wooden rollers to accurate size. I will also have to include an axis just a centimeter longer. That would have been just okay with me. But no, life doesn't work like this. Life's a Let's continue. Perfect. I need to find the absolute center. The intersections of my line are just not in the center of the smaller circle. Theory sucks. Just gonna do it like by feel. That's what I'm gonna do. Right, so that's it for the rollers. I've got 2 rollers with axes included. Now I need to move on to the thickness adjustment setting. Theory. You've got the top roller and you've got the bottom roller. Both of them are spinning in opposite directions. which means that the dough is gonna be sucked in. Problem. It's always about the problems. Problems are fun. I mean, I think they're... You see, getting one roller closer to the other is not a big problem. You could be using an endless screw or whatever. The problem is that those rollers are connected. That connection can be made through a belt or using gears, whatever. It's always the same problem. It doesn't allow for a space adjustment between those two elements. This time we are not only working with two elements, in fact we have three elements, because there is a conveyor belt right here. What matters isn't the distance between the two rollers, but between the top rollers and the plane right here. You think it's not helping, but in fact it is. Rotating the whole thing and bringing the roller to this position, still having the same distance between the bottom and the top roller, but then having the distance between the top roller and the plane much shorter. The only thing I need to do now is to find a way to make that top roller slide from this top position to its bottom position. Piece of cake. I know what you see. You're seeing like a wobbly, dusty machine, but I see a crispy croissant. I see a promise. Croissant! And that's called vision. Or fantasy. Let me just get this machine a bit more stable. Okay. Oops. Something fell off. Right, so to adjust the thickness of the dough you're working on, this is gonna slide within this slot, okay? The problem is, how do you know exactly at which thickness, like in millimeters for example, you're staying at? Solution, I'm gonna use a hand combined with a pin. 5 millimeters, click, clack. Perfect. I mean, in theory at least. Now the only thing left is to calibrate the machine in terms of, you know, thickness settings. And for this, I'm gonna use a few wedges. This is 6 millimeters in thickness. This is now 6 millimeters. I'm super pleased with the result. It's not finished yet, of course. It works like so. There's a pin right there. You remove it, then you adjust the target thickness. Let's go to 26, for example. And then you would secure the hand in place using the pin. And then when you're flattening, the whole machine will keep super steady and super solid at 26. That is my very unbiased opinion about this. I know, words will be words. Let's just give it a field test, okay? I got some leftover dough in the fridge. Let's flatten it. 14 millimeters. 6 millimeters. 4 millimeters. It should be 4 millimeters. The pressure is on, because otherwise the whole thing is just useless. 4.5 millimeters. It's unacceptable! No, it's acceptable. So yes, I'm pleased with the result at the moment, but no, I'm not fully satisfied deep inside. So overall, I'm looking for more precision, I'm looking for better mechanical parts, and also I'm looking for, you know, a tiny but powerful electrical input. That's what I'm looking for. If you enjoy the ride, if you enjoy the croissant series, then please subscribe to the channel for more food/random videos. Take care, bye bye, salut.